Hello and welcome here in the Victam newsroom. My name is Gerrit Heikoop and I'm here trying to find out what's hot, what's new and what's important in the international animal feed production industry. And one of the hot topics that we have discovered is feed and food safety. Earlier I talked to Johan den Hartog, who is the managing director of GMP Plus, and he explained about the GMP Plus safety framework. Then later I talked to Justina Maczynska of Trow Nutrition, who talked about how she tried to implement that framework in her international cooperation. And in this episode, we're even zooming in deeper. We're trying to make it more practical because I'm very honored to be joined by Tipang Narkmeet. You're an international auditor for Control Union, and you guys actually go into the factories and check whether all these safety measures are in place and are applied. So tell us a little bit about where do you do these audits?
All right. Basically, I'm not only audit in Thailand, but I'm also audit in several countries in the Southeast Asia as well. For example, in Malaysia, in Vietnam, and Indonesia, and sure, in Thailand.
Yeah, and who asks for these audits? Who are you auditing for? Is it the factories and the companies themselves, or is it by legislation?
Yeah, following the requirement of GMP Plus FSA or Feed Safety Assurance. So it basically is about the manufacturing process. So then I have to be requested and have to go into the factory. So then they go or check through all requirements that they need under the scope.
Now, let's imagine tomorrow you're visiting my factory,
right?
And you come do an audit at my place. Can
yes.
you talk us through what does it take? What does it take before you arrive, at, and after?
Yeah, I think for following the requirement, for the GMP Plus is the GMP Plus standard. It's not only the quality of the products, but it's about the safety. So safety of food guaranteed by the system. So then what are we going to check? We're going to check all the management thing and management team, the top management and operations. And then we go through all the procedure and what are they going to produce the following the product spec that request by the client and following the EU regulations.
All right, so you come check my procedures, my documentation.
Right.
Do you also do measurements inside the facilities?
Yes, the measurement in terms of the knowledgeable and how do they control and how do they measure control of all hazards that can be happened to the products, risk and safety.
And from your experience, what are the things that most people have difficulty with to apply and what advice do you have for them to make that better?
Yeah, actually, international auditor, as our role, cannot advise anything to the...
Right, but you see where people have difficulty, right?
Yeah, because the different place and different managing things, so they have different operating things. However, most of the concerning in Asia and especially in Southeast Asia is about cleanliness.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hygiene.
Yeah, because most of the feasting in Asia is quite long time that they did it has anciently. So then the managing has to be go through more and the understanding of people that operating those things. They have to get more in touch if the requirement and I think the GMP Plus standard and other standards as well have more potential that can improve them to be better.
All right. And so hygiene is a big important topic.
Right.
Other topics that you see that are important for people here in the Southeast Asian area?
For this thing, I think about the risk assessment.
Yeah.
Yeah. For example, like some fish oil is about the dioxins. So it's more globally concerned by the EU.
Yeah.
And then if we import some product in there, if they foul, or they detected some of the dioxin in there. So it's going to be very big concern and the product will be rejected.
Exactly. Now to all those feed manufacturers watching, what would be your ultimate advice? What would you like them to do moving forward?
I think in Southeast Asia and especially in Asia, we have already system in place. We have already the factoring and manufacturing infrastructure ready to go and we can support globally marketing, but the more of thing is that the standard. And I think not only the GMP Plus requirement, but the whole chain of feed safety, like the transportation and the trading activities, the ownership and the transportation, even abridgment. They are all important to whole chain, because if the factory or the manufacturing is good, they produce it, the products very good and very safe. But if the one who handling after and previously not concerning is going to be contaminated, so it's going to...
Then all your efforts and all your investments are useless, basically. So your advice would be to look outside your own responsibility and look at the whole chain.
Correctly.
Well, that's a strong piece of advice, very practical. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
And thank you very much for watching this video all the way to the end. If you're curious about the other videos we created about the GMP Plus framework, make sure you check out our YouTube videos at Victam International YouTube page. Hit the subscribe button so you'll be the first to know when a new video comes out, or surf to victam.com and subscribe to our newsletter. I just hope to see you in person at Victam 2019 in Cologne, or back here in Bangkok for Victam Asia 2020. Thank you for watching.